Hi guys, it's me, Karen. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to do a page in Magical Dawn. In this whole book, we're doing it in purple, red, blue, and green, adding a little brown if we need to, add skin tone if we need to, but it's basically those colors. We're going to do this page here, and because she has some skin, we're going to do a little bit of skin color on her. And then work on the other colors. So I'm going to get you down a little closer and we will get to working. Okay, we're going to do her skin first. And I've got a couple of colors out. We use light flesh in the pink colors we use. I have a deco peach, pink rose, maybe for some cheeks. Nectar is also used in the pink colorations. And then I have a dark umber I may or may not use. And depends on how we get going here and what I want to do with the skin tone that I'm going to have here. We're going to start off with this very small little light flesh here. I checked both of my sets of Prismacolor. I don't think I have a bigger one. Maybe this one. What are you? Nope, you're a scholar pencil. I know you're in there for a reason. yeah, I don't see one. So we're working with this little pup. So we're going to go around and add it in and lightly put it on. Her lightest areas here. Try to get some kind of definition in, but very lightly, so I kind of know what I'm doing here. So how's everybody doing? It's been a while since I've colored in this book, and I'm going to have to lay down a couple sheets of just plain paper. We have stickles on the other side, and I just want to pad it a little bit. How much of this earring you want to be transparent or see-through. You have to decide that while you're doing this. I think we'll have it like that. And the rest of that. It's okay. Go down the neck. Kind of a shadow under there. Something like that. Okay. Here is about where our cheek hollows come in, so I'll make a mark there. Okay. Next color. Kind of a medium flesh tone. Let's see what I got in here. Do do do. It's one of the reasons I like the polychromos. Light, medium, and dark flesh tones. What are you? Well, you're just nectar, so we'll go in with nectar. Darken some areas. I want a flatter edge on that. Just darkening it here, but trying to do it light. Come back with a few colors. It's been a while since I've done a skin tone in these pencils. Kind of have to get used to your pencils again when you switch them around. We'll bring in a little bit of the Deco Peach. Flatten that edge. Deco Peach is very soft, pinky peach. Okay, we're going to bring back in our original peach, which is your light peach. It's the one we started with. Okay, we're going to bring in a little of the henna. I'm going to flatten the edge of that. It's a little darker color. I really need to flatten that. Flatten it is just getting a flat surface on here so when I put it down I can do it a little softer so it doesn't have an edge on it. I just want to add in a bit of the color. I don't want to just slap it down in there. Sorry for the loud car. I've tilted it so I'm getting a little bit more colored coming down. And when I go over the stickle marks, I'm going around them basically just to blend them in a little bit because they are going to come out darker. Find my flat edge again. Going with the Deco Peach. Nope, that's not the Deco Peach. Where's the Deco Peach? Maybe I'll go in with the Peak Rose. Get a flat edge on that too. There we go. Bring a little of that up towards the eye. Okay, now we'll go in with the Deco Pink or Peach. try to soften that up a little bit. Okay, we're going in with our light peach. Blend that just a bit more. It's all coming from this little guy here, but we'll work on that. It's one of the things when you put stickles on the other page, you could be mindful of just darkening these areas a bit. Get our shadow going behind everything a little nicer. Now we've built up a lot of wax on here, so we are going to be kind of smearing things in. Now, I'm going to add a little white in here just to keep that bright. Highlight there. Going to add some in her eye here. A bit on her nose. Tiny bit on her forehead, a little under her eyebrow here. A little on her chin. And then add it anywhere you want to blend a little better, like this little spot right there. Kind of want that gone so you can get rid of that. Just lightly here. Thank you. Okay. I'm just going to put white on those little marks that we had down here. Lighten them up a little bit. Okay, can add just a skosh more of the light peach. We'll have to go back over that with the white. Okay, going to leave her skin alone for a little bit, and we're going to go in with her hair. And like I said, we do everything in purples, blues, pinks, and greens. So I thought we'd do her hair in purple. Sharpen that. I think I have to sharpen everything. It's been a while, like I said. Okay, so the purples are grayed lavender, Parma violet, and black grape. And what we're going to do, oh, we can do our eyebrow first. We're going to go in here with the dark black grape. Darken the bottom. Go in with a little Parma violet and lighten a little bit more towards the top. And then the gray lavender at the tip. Okay. And there we have our color range. We're going to take the dark grape and just kind of go up with some lines. It's like this little tiny speck of blue in there. It's driving me nuts. I'm not even sure where it came from. Probably the white pencil, but who knows? That's better. Okay, so then we're going to go up into her hair. We're going to go in with the black grape at the top. Am I up at the top where you can see? We're going to section these little pieces off. Like here is a section here. We're just going to bring black grape down, maybe even exaggerate that line a little bit. There. Then we're going to bring in the Sorry. Parma violet, and add in the gray lavender right in here. And pull it across that area. Parma violet in here. And then the dark. Blend those colors together. Just like that. You notice these pencils will have a lot of crumbly things coming out. So you have to wipe those up. I don't want it looking too much like hair because none of the others in the book do, but I'm just going to blend it like that, each little section. So I'll start off as a dark area. And if it gets to the point where you're not catching as dark as you want, bring in a little black. Just get that tiny bit darker right where you want it. Okay. And the Parma violet. Gray lavender. Ooh, move the book. And then the black grape. tiny little black. Okay, a little dust off of there. If you want, you can bring in a little of the white. I might need to get a bigger white. I'm pretty sure I have one in here. When you do a book all in one color, you tend to use a lot of pencil. So if anybody's curious, so far in the book, I am not done with it, by the way. I mean, maybe halfway, maybe a little more than halfway. I have used, just a little bit of white just to highlight these just a skosh better. And I've bought open stock colors to help with that. I've used black raspberry. I think I've bought two extra pencils of. I have two sets of Prismacolors, both 150 sets, and I used up the black raspberry, the light flesh. Of course, the white and the black, the green sets I've had to take out of both sets, and I'm working on the second set of those. The green isn't used as much as the pink or the blue. So at least two pencils each of every color that I've used in the book. The black and the white, I have bought big boxes of just those colors because I use those in other areas too, but I bought 12 of those separately. Everybody else, it's the light flesh I have to buy the most because I'll use it in other books. Indigo is another one that I use a lot in books, so there's more of those bought. I do love the black raspberry, so I use that in a lot of other things too. So basically, at least two sets of these have gotten into the book already. And I'm working on some of these are threes. So if you're going to work along in this book and do the same thing, keep that in mind. You can buy these open stock. I can. I go onto eBay and I just put in the color that I want and I can find them there. I don't know if they sell them at online pencil shops. Usually I just go to eBay and pick up my supplies. It's easy and quick for me that way. Our pencil shops that I usually buy from or pen shops are in the UK and take longer to ship than if I was to buy them on eBay. Okay, so we're just going to keep going through here. It'll get boring after a while. In this section here, it's pretty dark, so we're just going to go ahead and, because you've got the flowers on top of everything, and you kind of want a shadow in there. You want the flowers to stand out, so we're just going to kind of go in there with the black grape. Maybe we'll leave that a little lighter down there. Okay, and then just go in with your other colors. It also depends on how much pressure you put on your pencils, what time of year you're using your pencils. I don't know if you've noticed that Prismacolors, because they do have a lot of wax in them. All pencils have some sort of wax in them, but I mean, it's a binder that holds the lead together. Prismacolors have more than other sets. That during the summer, if it gets warm in your house, the pencils are a little more pliable. Because this one's so dark, I'm going to put a little lighter color up here. And here I wanted some lightness. Out here I want a little more darkness. So we're just going to take a line of black right up here. That's reason. Okay, that's good. Just gonna darken it a bit there. Okay, let's see, lightness in there. And then going with the darkness. Sharpen this one again. So you're just switching between all three colors, dark first and medium and then the light. Dust. We're gonna add a little white in here. A little black. Okay, we just keep working on it. I don't know how much of this you want to watch. Oops, what happened to my grade lavender pencil? And a touch of white somewhere in here. Okay, I'll finish this little part and then I'll do the rest of that off of camera because I'm going to have to take a break here. Okay, so So we'll stop doing that part. There's a lot more work to do. I mean, you got to make sure it's all blended. Not really that close to get it all blended, but you don't want the white paper showing through. Put a little more pressure on that and get that pencil in there. Okay, so the rest of her hair will be done like that. And yeah, I think that's where we're going to stop. Like I said, I'll finish the rest of that off camera. And next time we'll get into the flower section here and finish off her skin. I'm going to be adding another couple colors into it and doing an inking background. Some of those colors are going to come into her face. So her face is going to be a work in progress. So thanks for watching, guys. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below and I'll get to them as soon as I can. And I will see you in part two. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And I will see you in the next part. Take care, everyone. Bye now.